fields beyond the sky and far beneath the sea. A dapper lad stayed out of sight and fancied himself free. Tending to his hive of hair, his head you'd call hirsute, and stuffed into his pumly-wumly periwinkle suit. A pumly-wumly periwinkle suit no one would see. Hidden as he was, o'er the fields, beyond the sky, and far beneath the sea. 'Twas a ravish, gay ensemble, a dapper little number. It stayed upon him night and day, and even in his slumber. In his bed and in the bath, in weather wet and dry, he sported it without so much as loosening his tie. Jacket fitted to accentuate his supple frame, with fabric so divine, we dare not call it by its name. Slacks hand-stitched by 50,000 fairies with aplomb. In retail stores, they'd have to fetch a mighty hefty sum. He powdered and he preened before the mirror at his guise, batting humbly-wobbly periwinkle bedroom eyes. A powder purple petticoat, a blouse as smooth as glass, a valiant vest that really upped the ante of his class. Sleeves woven from drops of rainbow dew, with cuffs to match, an emerald-encrusted collar, he was really quite the catch. Stockings made of licorice in gold-lined underwear, booted scorchered montogram and slick beyond compare. The entire kit was pressed to within inches of its life, and decorous accoutrements about the suit were rife. Buttons built from moonstones, and cufflinks haute couture, tie pin in lapel, and quite a fashionable allure. Tips of wings adorned his shoes to make him look astute. Feathers lined his hat that was adorned with bootleg fruit. And all of this to just complete his pumbly-wobbly periwinkle suit. Call him mad or call him vain, so self-absorbed was he. O'er the fields, beyond the sky, and far beneath the sea. And yet, a nagging gnawed his soul.
What glory can there be to sport such an exquisite suit no one will ever see?
He sat and wondered, pained and pondered, plotting soon to flee. O'er the fields and to the sky and back above the sea, charting out the fastest route to cheers and adulation, from lesser folk bound to invoke the right to approbation.
I long for clues of ahs and oohs.
He sniffed and took a drag of his insouciant cigarette, but then he caught a snag. He sighed and folded up his maps.
'Tis such a long commute.
'Twas what he said the day he shed his pumbly-wumbly periwinkle suit.